Some ghost towns never really die. Some come back to life, resurrected. And when that happens, they have another chance to live. Christmas is that time for Calico Ghost Town. It's one of those places that attracts visitors year-round, yet it's a special time of year that really piques my interest. It gets me thinking about the people who were here when this town began. What brought them here to the middle of the Yermo Desert in 1881 in the first place? It wasn't the railroad. It was the silver. At the height of its silver production, there were over 500 mines and a population of 1,200 people. Today, visitors can wander the trails, but are not permitted in the abandoned mines. None of them are maintained and could collapse. As for accommodations at the time, they included 3 hotels, 3 boarding houses, and other primitive choices. It's such a contrast to see the primitive desert surroundings and the modern lights down below in town. And it's a small town too, but it's got so much spirit, this time of year especially. It's quirky too, with buildings like this one made of glass bottles and the crooked house. Yet its true age is revealed when you see how they used to put out fires, bucket brigade style. It's the magic hour now, but Calico Ghost Town has its own magic. When all of the Christmas lights come on, it's like a defiant symbol. This town refuses to go dark. It lives again and shines its brightest now. I hope that you get to visit Calico Ghost Town and discover the charm and magic for yourself. I'm Maureen Barley, and I'll see you around California.